When Toby Gard first created Lara Croft, he had no idea a controversy was also conceived. For the past decade, Lara has been dubbed both feminist icon and pixelated play toy.
In terms of how females have been portrayed in games up until Tomb Raider 1, they had been often portrayed purely as objects, and normally damsels in distress or just terrible fantasy sort of dominatrix-type characters.
But Lara was born during the late 90s, the height of what the Spice Girls called girl power. Even still, at the time, convincing execs to let a woman star in her own game proved difficult.
Traditionally, all games had male characters because they were played by boys. But these boys hadn't stopped playing games, they just got older. And what would they rather look at? Hedgehog, plumber, or Lara Croft's firm bum? With the benefit of hindsight, no pun intended, there's an obvious answer.
Male gamers swooned for Lady Lara, a sex symbol for the digital age.
Are men only interested in you because of your body?
No, I'm rich too, darling.
Women have also fallen in love with her kick-ass, no-nonsense attitude. A former editor at Ms. magazine, Jennifer Baumgardner, is a prominent woman's advocate who writes for Harper's and NPR.
Lara Croft is, she's just simply in the tradition of a long line of women who can protect themselves and who are warriors, from Xena the Warrior Princess to Buffy the Vampire Slayer. It's good to have protagonists that are women. So not just the people who are being saved are women, but the people that can do the saving are women.
But not every woman dug Lara. When Tomb Raider 2 dropped, Eidos advertised the new game with a series of commercials that played up Lara's sexiness. As fans rushed to stores to buy Tomb Raider 2, the controversy heated up. Ismini Roby is the chief editor and co-founder of WomenGamers.com, the largest women's game portal on the internet.
They put her in bikini photo shoots and anything that they could to make her even more appealing to that fanboy audience. To watch Lara Croft be marketed more as a sexual object, I was extremely disappointed.
So was Lara's creator. In fact, Toby Gard left the franchise over the new portrayal. Still, when well-known feminists like Jermaine Greer argued that the heroine was nothing more than an adolescent fantasy, Gard took objection.
I think that her comment of Lara Croft being a sergeant major with balloons stuffed up his shirt is a little bit like saying any sensitive guy who has any non-macho tendencies is just a woman with like banana stuffed down her trousers, and I think that it's nonsense.
Thanks to Tomb Raider Legends' more realistic model of Lara in 2006, the uproar died down a bit. But that hasn't stopped the headbutting over the legacy of the video vixen.
In our society, there's a big focus to be thinner. There's a certain kind of woman that everybody kind of wants to be, the tall, the thin, with the big breasts. It would be interesting to see companies making more realistic varieties of women.
I don't think that having those sorts of fantastic, idealized images out there in the world are what girls who have issues with self-esteem, I don't think they're comparing themselves to a video game.
If Lara Croft was a real person, she would not be able to walk. Her back would not be able to support her boobs. And to see Lara Croft scaling a mountainside with makeup and really short shorts, completely unrealistic.
Well, as a feminist, I guess I come down pretty hard on the side that if Lara Croft wears revealing clothes, hey, she's got it. She should flaunt it.
Love her or hate her, there's no doubt that Lara is here to stay.